Alrighty guys, Draginath here with a battle against a random player. Just wanted a quick pickup match and I obliged to him. So, let's see how it goes. I bring in my spear tomb and I go for a wisp as he stealth rocks and poisons me. And basically right now I'm just going to do what spear tomb does best and try and spread around as much damage as possible before I kick the bucket. I'm not really too worried about this thing, but I see he has an energy ball, and that immediately tells me that this is a starter set, a starter build for his Armaldo, so it's designed to die as well. It's not designed to be any sort of have any sort of longevity, so I'm going to use this as an opportunity to bring in my Fable and just start setting up. I know it can't touch me on either front, so I'm basically just going to just try and get some field control with Michael Fable here, and so that's exactly what I do. I set up the cosmic power as he toxics me. He had forgotten that magic guard prevents me from taking any damage from it, so basically he was kind of kicking himself in chat for making me sleep immune, and I'm just gonna keep sitting here cosmic powering all day until the burn kills him or I get bored. Boredom comes sooner than later, so I decided to just seismic toss it to move the game along, because watching me cosmic power is not very entertaining. But anyway, he brings in a blast toys. I'm not particularly afraid of it. I decide to get some damage on it because I don't feel it can really do anything to me, even with a focus blast. And after seeing how much it did, it's about maybe a quarter of my health, I decided I'm just going to seismic toss this thing and just finish it off quickly before he gets the chance to switch. Before he drops, I decide to set up one more layer of cosmic power just to be safe. It's kind of a why not situation. I have the encounter one, so I'm just preparing for whatever else he decides to bring in after he weakens me a little bit. So already Clefable is 2 for 2, and he brings in a Lucario. I was not afraid of this thing at first, but after seeing the Aura Sphere and Life Orb and how much it did with 3 layers of cosmic power, I started to kind of panic. I was getting a little cocky here, and I knew I have to soft boil up right here, otherwise all that setting up would have been a waste of time. And luckily, the Aura Sphere doesn't kill me, leaves me with just enough to get a soft boil up. And here he uses extreme speed for an inexplicable reason. I guess he just wanted to see how much it did, or maybe it was a misclick or whatever, and I just soft boil up to full. And then he swords dances, and I was thinking he was going to go for something like close combat or something, but he just Aura Spheres again. And I would have kind of chuckled to myself, but then I saw he gets a crit. And even a crit, it still killed my Clefable here, which I was personally surprised at. Life Orb, super effective. I guess it's workable, but still was pretty surprising with 4 layers of cosmic power up. But anyway, I decided to bring in my Revenge Killer there, my Magneton. He can't escape me, so he just has to eat the Thunderbolt and I finish it off. Then he brings in this Charizard, probably thinking he's going to outspeed me, but he doesn't, and I can get off a second Thunderbolt and get a free kill. He decides to bring in this thing. I can't do anything against it, so I bring in my own Torterra, and it's shiny, so it's better anyway, so yeah. He Sunny Days up, and I wasn't really sure what he was planning on doing with the Sunny Day. So I just decide to stealth rock, try and get some residual damage base, because I still haven't seen maybe 2 of his Pokemon, or maybe just 1. Anyway, I decide to just wood hammer, times 1 effect, it hits for a significant amount, and he stone edges me, which doesn't do anything. I see he has Giga Drain as his grass move, and it doesn't really do much to me. It does a decent amount, considering Torterra's special attack, but it's still not much for me to be worrying about it anytime soon. So basically, I'm just going to wood hammer this thing and try and finish it off real quick. So after the wood hammer, I managed to take this thing down. And I just realized he does have one more Pokemon. So he brings in this thing. I'm not afraid of it at all. I know that I have the match one already. He drill pecks me to finish off my Torterra. And I'm just going to bring in my Magneton and finish it off. So, a little rusty, but I finally have my DS set up here at the college, so I'll be able to get more games in for you guys, and hopefully as 5th gen comes in, I'll be able to post some videos of that too. So until next time, guys, peace.